the man is like he's from another planet.
When he gets his hands on the ball, he just has to run.
I haven't always been seeing that. He doesn't even know. He just does it. And you're like,
they just saw an amazing video cassette presented by Sports Illustrated, starring the most exciting figure in sports today.
Who else?
Jordan.
I knew they were the first
Filipinos that came to America. You know, I mean, and then knowing something about them later, in the later years, you know. He stood for us.
Back home, when we were lucky to go to school, Christian brothers would tell us about the States. We believe in White Christmas by Bing Crosby. And we also believe in God and the Church.
You always had that knock. Carlos, that knock on that door. They had all those nuns waiting outside because they saw it was like five girls, five boys, and the boys were either going to end up being priests, and the girls, nuns. And we couldn't help believing in White Christmas and God here. But we also had, you know, we had all kinds of gods there, you know, right? Rice gods, fish gods, you know, fish eye gods, you know, right? Fishtail gods, water buffalo gods. That's why you and I are so confused.
The American, dream is not ours. We are not citizens.
I used to wonder, Carlos, about that. I used to wonder, what side is the water buffalo on? You know, because here you have these guys coming over, right? Turning over the soil, and they come over here, and they're in the fields, right? Turning over the soil, and every head of lettuce, every apple, and pear, and orange, and walnut was picked by them. I mean, could you,
That's a good feeling.
And, and yet these guys were not able to become citizens.
We come here and we find jobs in the kitchen, in the canneries, and chasing the crops up and down the West Coast. One in aggregate.
You know, Carlos, I remember this one Manong in a place called Agbayani Village, you know, that's out by Delano. You know, you have these guys that are about 90 years old, still living in the shacks, you know, who, like, when they were in the Watsonville field, before that season ended, they were preparing to go to Alaska, and then from Alaska to Watsonville. So, I mean, their life was so full that there was no time for them to think. I mean, it's like they had to go with their feeling, their style.
No jobs, no Pinoys allowed. They call us monkeys. What do they think of us now?
Beautiful monkeys. Carlos, I remember, you know, they used to say, Carlos, how you dance that way? How you dance that way?
They promise us a place we cannot live in. They give us a reality that we cannot believe. We work so hard, we get so little. We go back again so we can get very little money. What do we do?
Well, you listen maybe to some of these old timers. Let's say, when you came here way back and you gave your soul and your mind and your spirit and your body to America, how did you do it? And he looks at you and he says, you know what, Carlos, you see that coconut tree? I climbed the tallest coconut tree to the moon, and the moon said to me, you know what, I want you to go over there, to see the other side of your faith. So I think the Manongs are looking for the other side of their faith. You know?
Well, Manong out there. Manong Hill is a red top-down car.
Very nice.
Yes, pomade.
Three flowers. Thick Vaseline.
Yes, a suit.
Thick shoulders.
He has fluorescent shoes.
Polished like the sun.
He has a beautiful trousers.
Up to here? Suspenders.
And he has a one-inch belt.
A guapo.
Maganda.
Maganda.
After asparagus season, he pay cash for the car. He works 6 days a week.
But never buy a house, though.
But he never miss a day.
Carlos,
Manong Hildo is very lucky.
You know, there's a lot of Hildos. You know, a lot of Hildos, you know. There's something about their dress. You know, and there's something about their style, you know. I mean, why did these guys come over to a place called America where they were unwanted spirits, forgotten? Silence Manongs who live in the forgotten shacks of America now, wallowing and wailing, echoing the remnants of the past. And still, they had this thing. You know, I mean, what was it that they had?
It was love. It was
love. I think it was love, Carlos. It was very much
you
love.
You belong to my heart now and forever. Our romance and its heart, not long ago. We were gathering stars, one a million guitars, played our love song. Darling, you are the one, and you'll always belong to my heart.
In Delano, I was dancing with a blondie.
Oh, maganda.
And I said to her, my love for you is like the desert.
Oh.
And she says to me, is that why you dance like a camel?
That's right. But Carlos, you know, Carlos, a lot of blondies could be Eskimo too, you know.
I have seen that.
I've seen that too. Right. And that they say that maybe like the dancers, that the way they dance, the reason why they were able to move the way they were able to was because, you know, in the farm, the sugar cane, Manong, when they cut the sugar cane, when they pick the pears, when they trim the grapes and the grape orchards, there was a kind of thing. They said, we want the brown Filipino to, you know, what was this thing? I mean, what was this, you know? Huh, Fred? What was your style, Fred? You know? What was it?
Well, I was making money style.
You know, I mean, you know, even if they say, like, you know, I mean,
Five cents an hour style.
That's right, and the taxi dance, right? 5 cents, 5 cents an hour, 10 cents an hour. These guys, I mean, can you imagine, Carlos, like you said, like 5 o'clock in the morning they get up, 4 o'clock, to watch the asparagus. The asparagus, and they, you know, and they, I mean, they'll stop, you know, like so.
And to hear the rooster crow.
The rooster, oh, tell me about the rooster. Tell me, come on.
The rooster was beautiful.
Oh, God.
The rooster was very, very beautiful.
And it had like, not like this, huh?
No, guapo.
But God damn, every time I drive my car with my townmate, I get stopped by the street cop all the time.
Why?
They get me out of the car and they think I'm a goddamn pimp.
Because you dress up the way you are now, huh? Beautiful, huh? Carlos, let me see your shoes.
But he is jealous.
See, that's
he's jealous of me. He envies me so much.
Carlos, you know, I think during those days you had the Irish police force, right? Who you know, who had these you know, these buttons, and all he had was this huge club, and he didn't like looking at brown folks or black folks or meat folks, you know. And when he saw them with a blondie, he would just bust them over the head. Tell me. And yet these guys with their songs, their dancing, were able to,
they have a rhythm.
That's it, the rhythm. And Carlos, I think that's it, the rhythm. There's a tribal rhythm. And had there not been, they would not be able to have survived.
Serve by the humor.
You know what? I mean, I thought that, you know, what is funny? I mean, these guys would say, you know, you look at a fish, right? And they'll go, you know, you go into a restaurant, right? I mean, humor. And this guy over there, he'll say, you know, in the restaurant, he'll say, Mama, where's my fish head? Who's Mama, right? And Mama comes out with the fish head, gives it to Fred, you know? And he starts talking about all these things, you know, of like how important it is, like food, how, you know, so with the humor and with the, but you don't have any of that other stuff, you know, all that lonely stuff, you know, like, you know, because they want to make it here, this dream, and go back to this, you know, so they're always, how do you laugh, you know, how do you laugh when you're, you know, Carlos Blusan?
Well, what about going back dreams to La Pobla?
Yeah, you know
what? About going home?
Going home?
Do you think about going home?
Yeah, I think about going home, and how I think about going home when there's these two words, you know, they're kind of like, you know, not overly sentimental, but you know, and it kind of like it hits you there because, like, you know by just the sound, you know, just the sound. I mean, if somebody, your Kapibayans in Manila Town or wherever are around and you hear a certain sound or them or what have you, or...
Did they save a lot of money to go back?
Yeah, like going back meant like fulfilling this this dream, but they die. They die, they go back, they don't exactly, some of them don't make it. Some, when they make it like 50, 60 years later, and they die.
What about gambling? What about gambling?
Gambling is a, you know, something about gambling. It, well, I don't think it came from, did it come from the Spanish?
Who are they? What do you think? Who are they?
Well,
who are the Manongs?
See, the Manongs, when I grew up, I thought they were just Filipinos, just ordinary guys, my neighborhood family, you know, I mean, they were just there. And then as time went on, you know, moved into like the 60s, and then I saw where like the Manongs were battling with the oppressor, the unions, the sugarcane fields, and then in Agbayani village was Cesar Chavez, all the Manongs were there. And then the last, who were they? The Manongs that fought for the life in the place they wanted, as their home, in Kearney Street, San Francisco, Manila Town, International Hotel, their home. Who are these guys? These guys are your brother. They are your papa. They are your life. They are your tribal link to what is now. They are your vision, Carlos.
But what are they doing? What are they doing now?
They are living the last days of their life. Now, collecting that little thing they call SSI for nothing.
But where are they?
They are in the little shacks in Watsonville, Abani Village. They are in the little tiny rooms along 6th Street, International Hotel. They are in the Casa Playa Hotel. They're in Watsonville, Guadalupe. They are all around, forgotten and silent. They are unknown. They're still out there, eating rice and fish still with their hands.
Where are they now?
Kantahin natin
magmamadala.
than you in December love. Baby, that's the only thing I am thinking of. Baby, tell me what you're sure to find. Happiness, and I guess all the things you find for. Yeah, I'd like to see you looking swell. Baby, diamond bracelet, gold or tan cell. Baby, tell that lucky day you know done well. Baby, I can't give you anything but love.
Matias here, banjo player, guitar player, Watsonville asparagus picker, and they're here to celebrate your feelings and their life with you with songs.
Yeah. Dahil sa